A double date on the Iberian Peninsula kicked off the opening fixtures on the European stage of the 2022 Championship, and it did not disappoint. Portimao and Jerez were the destinations, and with so much on-track excitement, you may not have caught everything that happened, so these are your other battles from the Portuguese and Spanish Grand Prix. There was drama from the very beginning in the Algarve, with Alex Rins getting a sensational launch from the line to climb 13 places into the top 10 from a P23 start. Once the opening lap was done, the Suzuki rider set about chasing down Paul Espargaro. It didn't take him too long to catch the Honda rider, and despite this turn 1 mistake on lap 3, he was back in front of his compatriot by the time they crossed the line again, thanks to a manoeuvre at turn 13. Rins ended the day 4th, while it left Espargaro in a factory Honda shootout with Marc Marquez, with the two dueling for top 10 positions in the early stages. It was full gas from both riders before this fight eventually went the way of the 8-time world champion. Just ahead of them, another Espargaro and Marquez were having a battle of their own. Aleix and Alex both put in strong rides in the south of Portugal, and they signalled their intentions early. The two competed inside the top 6 across the first 7 laps, with the LCR rider holding firm on more than one occasion as he came under pressure from the RSGP. Eventually, the Aprilia man's experience told in the end, as he moved into a top 5 position on the 8th lap and could begin to set his sights on a second podium of 2022. The trouble wasn't over for the younger Marquez sibling, as he was soon within reach of big brother Mark. The LCR rider managed to hold him off for the best part of 16 laps, only to be pipped to a top 6 finish at the death. Much like Alex Rins, Pecco Bagnaia found himself in the unfamiliar territory of starting on the back row, but the Italian managed to pull off an admirable Sunday salvage job. It wasn't quite the blockbuster start of the Suzuki, but the Ducati star did gradually climb through the field to wind up in a last lap battle with Honda's Espargaro. A collision between the two on the final lap saw the GP22 lose a wing, but it didn't stop Bagnaia from claiming a respectable P8. One week later, and it was Pecco perfection at the Grand Prix of Spain in Jerez. He went from pole to P1 to spark his championship campaign into life, while Fabio Quartararo and Aleix Espargaro joined him on the podium. An eventful race start saw rookie Remy Gardner lose his front wing after knocking into Alex Marquez between turns 2 and 3. Even with the lack of a full aero package, the Aussie completed the race, but was unable to finish inside the points. Alex Rins started the race in P14 and was hoping another sensational comeback was on the cards as he passed by LCR's Marquez, but a trip to the gravel trap on lap 9 put paid to those plans. That mishap left him in a battle with Aprilia wildcard Lorenzo Savadori and playing catch-up, but there was to be no heroics this time as he dropped points for the very first time this season. The final point scoring finish went to Franco Morbidelli. The factory Yamaha rider was battling with Alex Marquez in the opening exchanges, but despite his best efforts, couldn't get past the RC213V. Just ahead of the Italian Luca Marini and Maverick Vinales were going wheel to wheel for much of the race, with the Spaniard sticking a move by the VR46 rider on lap 21, coming in to turn number 7. Morbidelli then picked off his compatriot 2 laps later to move into P15. While a late lunge at turn 13 didn't quite come off, as Vinales and the RSGP responded immediately. A thrilling back-to-back opened up the European leg of the season, and we don't have to wait long for our next fixture with Le Mans up next for the Shark Grand Prix of France. Make sure you stay tuned to MotoGP.com for all the build-up and latest news.